Hello, darlings. Welcome to Tea with Justine. Today I am here with Dr. Cara Quant, who focuses on women's sexual health because it is very important for all of us to understand. So I know a lot of guys are going to be like, okay, this episode is not for me, but it is for you because our bodies are magical, which is what Dr. Cara is going to talk about.
It is very important for men to understand about the woman, about periods, about what women go through. I think it's so important, and I think that your part, if you are in a heterosexual relationship, I think it's important for your partner, for you to understand what your partner is going through.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Get on our level a little bit.
100%.
It would make communication a little bit better.
A lot better.
Yeah. Dr. Cara, why is female sexual health so important for us to understand?
There's so many reasons why. Biggest thing is because society doesn't put it out there. There's not a lot of information about women's sexual health. And I think that it can empower a woman to understand about her anatomy.
Yeah.
So I think that that's the biggest thing. It can empower her to go to the doctors. It can empower her to speak up. It can empower her to do many things when she understands what is going on.
Yeah.
If there's any issues going on with her vagina, vulva, things like that.
And I think just in general, we as women are more intuitive about our bodies and we pay more attention because a lot more goes on with our bodies.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So Dr. Cara is going to talk to us about the five magical things you might not have known about the vulva.
Mm-hmm. And there's way more than five, but these are the ones that I would say are good. But there's like a million.
Yes. I'm excited to find out how magical my body is.
Yes. First, I want to actually clarify what the vulva is. So the vulva is actually anything that you see on the woman. So the big and the small lips, the clitoris, the urethra, or the opening of the urethra, as well as the opening of the vagina. So everything that you can see is considered the vulva. So when we say vagina, that's actually wrong. And it's the vulva that we're looking at. First magical thing about the vulva is it's self-cleaning.
And I don't have to take as many showers. No, I'm just kidding.
We have good and bad bacteria within our vaginas. Mm-hmm. And there is something called douching, which I strongly don't recommend. And the reason why is because douching is like a solution that goes into the vagina and actually removes the good bacteria that's in the vagina. And so it can lead to more infection. It can lead to risk of infection. So it's self-cleaning, and all you need to do is use some gentle soap and water. Shower or bath, and cleaning the vulva is good enough. There's no need to do inserting anything, any solutions into the vagina because it's self-cleaning.
I feel like that in and of itself already makes it very magical.
Very magical, yes. The second one is the clitoris is actually only used for one thing, and it's pleasure. No other function of the clitoris. Just like our hearts can, you know, are used for pumping blood throughout our body, and our lungs are used to bring in oxygen and release carbon dioxide. Well, our clitoris is only used for one thing, and that's for pleasure. And so it's funny how society runs against that, doesn't promote self-pleasure. Third one is that women have the ability to have multiple orgasms. So for men, it is not that way because there is something called the refractory period. And the refractory period is a time after a man comes, he can no longer have an orgasm. But for women, it is not that way. Women can have back-to-back orgasms.
Can have more fun.
And women's orgasms last a lot longer than men's. So on average, it's 6 seconds for men and it's actually 10 seconds for women.
I think that's incredible because, you know, it's harder for us to orgasm, so.
It is, yeah. So we have the ability.
So we get a little bit of a reward.
We have a reward, and we can have multiple.
Yes. Yeah,
and it lasts longer when it does happen. So that is another magical fact about the vulva.
Awesome, awesome.
Fourth one is that when a woman is aroused, and I do want to emphasize when she is aroused, the vagina actually gets longer, so it elongates. And it lubricates to allow for penetration. So we have an accommodating part of our body.
The vagina is kind of crazy then, right? Because like when you give birth too, it has to expand. So it's really quite an incredible organ.
Which brings us to our last point and the most magical of the vulva, which is we have the ability to create life.
Yes. That is the most magical
thing.
That's
the most magical.
It's crazy.
Come on. It's the most magical.
A baby can come out of there. Yes. This is why men should pay attention to female health too. Because I think it makes us stronger. Like, I do, no offense, guys, but I think we are the stronger species.
100%. I do agree. I mean, I definitely agree. Yeah. We have the ability to create life.
Yes.
We have all of those other things that come along with the vulva and the vagina. I mean, I would say it is a powerful organ on our body. There's some books that have talked about we are sitting on the seats of our thrones. I mean, I think that's pretty powerful.
That is pretty powerful.
That's pretty
and
powerful,
very true.
Right?
That is true.
All of the men out there that have women partners, you have to respect the vulva, respect the vagina, because it is a magical organ.
Yes.
It is.
Well, thank you, Dr. Cara,
yes,
for
welcome.
Joining me for tea today and for enlightening us with how magical our female bodies are.
I thank you for allowing me to be here.
Yes, and you can check out her website, Viva La Vulva LA.
LA, yes, .com. Yes. .org, I'm sorry, .org.
And then also her social media. Stay tuned for more adventures in tea so we can discover the world together. And remember to subscribe to our channel and follow us on all your favorite social media platforms. And we will see you all next time.
Yes.
Toodles.
Viva La Vulva.
Yeah.